Network News, I'm Chuck Rice. An Oregon logging group is burning coffins representing timber towns. Environmentalists are talking of loopholes so big you could drive thousands of logging trucks through them. They're all reacting to President Clinton's new Northwest logging policy. Clinton acknowledges it probably won't make anybody happy. The plan would sharply reduce timber cutting in the Northwest forests. California sawmill operator Bruce Taylor says it'll mean a permanent loss of jobs at his mill.
With the big reductions that we had starting approximately two to three years ago, I mean, that led to us having to lay off one of our crews, one of our swing shift, and we had to lay off 125 people. And with this plan now, that's going to have to be permanent.
And the logging industry itself says there will be similar stories like that throughout the region. Clinton, in an effort to soften this blow, is offering more than $1 billion in economic aid to the region. Environmentalists are angry because Clinton's plan will allow even limited logging in old-growth forests where the northern spotted owl lives. Aides say Clinton has accepted the base closing commission's plan to close or scale back dozens of bases around the nation. In that case, it means the president has lost his political hot potato to the Congress. Overseas, the Pentagon is taking similar steps. Spokesman Captain Michael Doubleday says dozens of bases are being closed or reduced.
The 92 overseas sites represent the largest drawdown of its kind in 3 years. The list is the result of a vigorous effort to close unneeded bases overseas to focus our resources on the defense we need for the future.
Bases in Berlin and Frankfurt are being closed, and officials in both those cities are pleased to free up badly needed housing. The Centers for Disease Control is calling for a worldwide campaign to wipe out polio by the year 2000. Dr. Mary Riker says there are two major obstacles to eradicating this disease.
We do have effective vaccines, but we don't have optimal levels of vaccination coverage. A second reason is a financial reason. We have an inadequate commitment of financial resources at national and international levels to achieve polio eradication.
Dr. Riker says the cost of wiping out polio, $1 billion. Police in Macon, Georgia say a hostage situation at a shopping mall is over with a gunman under arrest. Police say both the gunman and his hostage have been taken to a nearby hospital. This is APA, Network News.
Thank you. come out here and talk to you about a new forest you plan or create. I'm not using the right phrases. It's just not. You're not.
No, this is, it's ancient forestry. It's not new forestry. It really is no forestry.
Taking it to court. I'm John Nielsen reporting.